There's plenty of room here. There's lots of room here. And this side also. So there's lots of room in the shade here. And this side also lots of room in the shade. Don't burn in the sun. By the causeless mercy of Sri Guru and Gauranga, as we perform our Sri Navadvipdham Parikrama, from the island of Antardvip, now we have come to the island of Simantadvip. And we have had the great fortune of the darshan of Sri Jagannath Baladev Subhadra. This place is called Saradanga. Once there was a Muslim king. And his mother was from a Hindu family, but she was kidnapped. By his father, who was also a Muslim king.
So,
when he grew up, then he was very much against Hinduism, because he was actually conflicted, because his mother was Hindu, so he compensated by being extra fanatical against Hinduism.
He
was going everywhere smashing temples. And he even had the audacity to try to invade Orissa
and
attack the temple of Lord Jagannath. So at that time, the king of Orissa arranged that just for the sake of safety, Lord Jagannath should be taken out of the Jagannath temple and hidden somewhere. So he brought Lord Jagannath here. Until the military the campaign was over, and then Lord Jagannath returned to
Jagannath Puri.
So actually, Supreme Lord, he moves by his own free will. So we think that this invasion only it was arranged by Lord Jagannath because he wanted to go to Navadvipdham. So how lucky you are, even Lord Jagannath, the Lord of the Universe, wants to come here. And from another perspective, Lord Jagannath is eternally here in Simantadvip, in Saradanga. Because just as all the incarnations, when Sri Krishna appears in this world, all the avatars enter into the body of Sri Krishna, so in the same way, when Mahaprabhu manifests Navadvipdham, so all the holy places are present here in Navadvipdham.
Подобно тому, как все ипостаси Господа, все инкарнации присутствуют в Махапрабху, все святые дамы присутствуют тут, на Навадвипдхаме.
We should not think that the holy places have come here, but rather the original Swarupa of all the holy places is present here.
Не думайте, что святые места переместились сюда. Нет, на самом деле тут изначально их формы присутствуют всегда.
Now the question comes, why is this island called Simantadvip? So hear very carefully, because Simantadvip is the island of hearing. Once in Kailash, Lord Shiva was remembering the ecstatic love of the associates of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he became overwhelmed in ecstasy. He began roaring, "Go!"
Yeah!
And playing his Damaru drum and dancing like a mad person. He was jumping here and there and rolling on the ground. So his wife Parvati was watching and she was in shock. She thought, what is he thinking? I don't understand the things that he's saying and the names that he's saying. So she didn't interfere at that time, she waited for him to cool down.
And then,
when there was an appropriate moment, she asked, oh my dear husband, please tell me, what ecstasy were you experiencing and why? Who were those names you were chanting?
Она выждала уместное время и в благоприятный момент обратилась к супругу и сказала, господин, пожалуйста, расскажи мне о том состоянии, которое ты испытывала. Кто эти личности, которых ты упоминал в трансе?
Lord Shiva said, O Devi,
Shiva сказал, о Деви,
see Krishna himself appears in the Kali Yuga with a golden complexion and divine sentiments of Shrimati Radhika in the form of Gauranga.
Сам Шри Кришна приходит в век Кали, украшенный золотым цветом тела Шримати Радики и ее бхавой настроением. И эту постать зовут Гауранга.
And he reveals the secrets of onomatodoxy. There's a word in Russian and in English also. Onomatodoxy means the theology that God and His holy name are non-different. And by revealing this mystery of the glory of the holy name, He inundates the whole world with love. Not only does he give this love to the pious people, but even to the criminals? So when Parvati heard this glorification of Gauranga from Lord Shiva, then she decided, I need to go to Navadvip Dham.
Когда Парвати узнала о вот этой ипостаси Господа Гауранги из уст своего супруга Шивы, она приняла решение, что ей следует отправиться в Навадвип Дхаму.
Why?
Почему?
Because she was thinking, I am deprived of prey.
Потому что она чувствовала себя лишенной премы.
I don't have love.
Думала, у меня нет никакой любви.
Because of my offenses.
Из-за моих оскорблений.
She was thinking that once upon a time there was a great devotee named Chitraketu Maharaj. He was the king of the Vidyadharas, flying here and there in an airplane that was given to him by Lord Vishnu. And one day, when he was flying, he looked down and he saw Lord Shiva sitting in the midst of so many Siddhas and Charanas and Brahma and Shiva Brahma and Narad, and so many Rishis were all there. And Lord Shiva was sitting with his wife on his lap and speaking Bhagavatam.
Летел и выглянул со своего вимана и увидел ассамблею там полубогов, чаранов, сид, и среди них сидел Господь Шива, на коленях у него сидела его супруга, и Шива рассказывал Шримад Бхагаватам.
So in Vedic culture, public displays of affection are not appreciated.
В ведической культуре вот такое выражение любви и знака внимания.
That is absolutely no. You cannot embrace your wife on your lap in the public place. What to speak of in front of the Shiva and Narad and the four Kumaras and all the sages and siddhas and charanas.
Для обычных людей это верхнее приличие там прижиматься к жене или там обниматься, сидеть, чтобы она сидела на коленях прилюдно. А что уже говорить, когда в ассамблее сидят такие великие святые, мудрецы, как Нарада?
So from his airplane, Chitraketu Maharaj said, oh, just look at that!
Chitraketu громко сказал из аэроплана, посмотрите.
Mahadev, the speaker of Dharma.
Mahadev.
With five mouths, he speaks Dharma.
Повествующий Дарму из своих пяти ртов.
But he's embracing his wife in public in front of everyone.
Сидит перед всеми, обнимая жену.
So when Parvati heard this,
как только Парвати услышала,
she became very upset.
Она очень разгневалась.
She thought, what is this?
Что это такое?
He's making a great offense.
Высмеивает моего мужа так публично.
If my husband Shiva was doing something wrong, do you think that Brahma and the Narada Muni and the four Kumaras and all these great worshipable, respectable personalities, do you think they would say something, right, if you were doing something wrong? But they're not saying anything.
Неприличное. Неужели бы такие личности, как Брама и все мудрецы, не вмешались и не протестовали бы его поведение? Но все сидят тихонько, кроме этого.
In fact, Lord Shiva is worshipable for Brahma, Narada and the four Kumaras. Vrindavana, Vanipate, Jaya, Soma, Soma, Mole, Sanakasananda, Sanatana, Naradicha.
Вообще объект поклонения для четырех Кумаров, Нарада и других.
So, and who is this Chittaketu?
А этот Читракету кто вообще?
By trying to give instructions to Lord Shiva and correct him in front of all these senior persons, he's actually stepping over the head of all of these seniors. And so he's making an offense.
То есть Парвати почувствовал, что это вообще не верхний, что-то он нарушает этикет, делая замечание ее супругу в присутствии старших личностей, таких как Брама, что он переступает как через их авторитет, чтобы сделать замечание ее супругу.
He's behaving like a demon.
Он потом ведет себя вообще как демон.
So then Parvati said, I curse you, you should fall down and become a demon.
Все, Парвати сказала, все, ведешь себя как демон, я тебя проклинаю, чтобы ты пал и стал демоном.
So then Chitraketu came down from his aeroplane.
Аэроплан Читракету приземлился.
And he gave dandavat pranam to Shiva and Parvati.
Вышел из него, поклонился Шиве и Парвати.
Now actually he's so powerful he could have made a counter curse to Durga even.
Деле он обладает достаточной силой, чтобы противостоять.
Because he's a pure devotee.
Он чистый преданный Господа, он может дать ей контрпроклятие тут же.
He said, because of my karma from
сказал,
previous lives.
Из-за своей кармы.
Then I have to be born in different situations.
Мне придется рождаться в разных ситуациях.
So now I will have to become a demon in my next life. I cannot say that you're at fault. It is my own karma.
И я не виню тебя за это проклятие. Я понимаю, что из-за собственной кармы мне придется теперь перевоплотиться, родиться в форме демона.
He did not even blame poverty.
Он даже не стал обижаться.
He took full responsibility for his own destiny.
Он не винил Парвати за это. Он принял ответственность на себя полностью за свое поведение, на свой.
And even though he said, "Oh, this has happened just due to my own karma," that was out of humility, because being a pure devotees don't have karma.
Он сказал, что это произойдет из моей собственной кармы, но это тоже не было фактом, потому что чистый преданный жив вне кармы.
You see?
У него нет кармы.
The Supreme Lord, he is the controller of Maya.
Верховный Господь – повелитель Майи.
Maya is the controller of karma.
Майя – повелительница кармы.
And the karma is controlling the living beings.
Карма контролирует живые существа.
But the pure devotee controls Krishna. So do the math. If the pure devotee who controls Krishna, how is it become? It will be under the control of karma, which is under the control of Maya, which is under the control of Krishna. Not possible.
Контролирует Кришну, то как он может быть под контролем кармы, которая под контролем Майи, которая сама под контролем Кришны?
So whatever Chitraketu Maharaj said, it was just completely out of humility.
Все, что сказал Читракету, это было проявлением его искреннего смирения.
But he accepted that curse.
Он принял это проклятие.
And in his next life, he was born from the fire sacrifice of Tvasta as a demon. Not really demon, but looking like a demon. Vitrasur.
И уже в следующем воплощении он родился из огня Твасты, из Яги и стал внешним демоном.
But Vaishnavas don't say Vritrasura, they say Mahatma Vritra. Common people can say Vritrasura, but Vaishnavas say Mahatma
Vritra.
So then Lord Shiva turned to Parvati.
Shiva повернулся к супруге.
He said, "Oh, why did you interrupt?"
Зачем ты вмешалась?
He was not criticizing me.
Не высмеивал меня.
You thought he was criticizing, but actually he wasn't.
Тебе показалось, что он делает мне замечание, но ты неправильно поняла его.
What is the praman?
В чем праман?
Because Shastra said, when a great personality is criticized, you have to cover your ears and leave that place.
Шастра говорит, если вы стали свидетелем каких-то нехороших слов в адрес великой личности, надо закрыть уши и покинуть это место.
Just like when Shishupal was criticizing Krishna, all the sages in the palace of Yudhishthira covered their ears and they left.
То есть, если при вас приходит какое-то нехорошее действие, оскорбляет Вайшнава, нужно покинуть это место, как во время Яги, Юдиштира Махараджа, когда Шишупал оскорблял Кришну, садху, и мудрецы встали, закрыли уши и стали удаляться оттуда.
So, because Brahma and Narada and all the rishis didn't cover their ears and leave, that means that what Chituketu Maharaj commented was actually not an offense. That's the Praman.
Ни Брама, ни Нарада, ни четверо кумаров никак не отреагировали на слова Читракету, значит, по факту они не были оскорбительными в адрес Шивы.
He was simply trying to reveal the glories of Lord Shiva. That being an Ishvara, very powerful, he is not subject to the laws of Dharma which are applicable to the conditioned souls. So that's his greatness, not his fault. And he was having a joke because he's good friends with Lord Shiva. Because they're both devotees of Sankarshan. So he wanted to have a friendly joke with Lord Shiva, and Lord Shiva was about to say to him, yes, I embrace my wife in public because I am very straightforward and simple. But you are acting like a devotee, but in private you have so many pastimes with the Vidyadhara ladies in your aeroplane. So Lord Shiva and Chituketu, they wanted to have some brotherly jokes with each other. But Parvati took it all the wrong way and cursed
him.
So Lord Shiva said to Parvati, Narayana parasaive na kutastani bibrati swarga apavaga narakeshu apituljata darshanam. Just see the character of a pure devotee like Chitraketu Maharaj. You have cursed him to become a demon, and he has just peacefully accepted it without any resistance. Because Narayana Parasave, those who are absorbed in the service of the Supreme Lord, then the external dualities of material existence, whether they are in heaven or in hell or whether they are liberated, it's all the same to them. Because they engaged in transcendental loving service to Sri Krishna, then wherever they are outwardly, they accept that to be Krishna's mercy, and then their minds are not affected by the illusory dualities of the material plane. But Parvati is also a pure devotee, so she also cannot make an offense. So how is it that she was inspired to curse him? It's very deep. Chituketu was enjoying the life in the heavens. He had a very long lifespan of thousands of years. But Krishna was feeling separation from him. He didn't want him to wait out his life thousands of years in the heavenly planets. So Krishna inspired Parvati to curse him so he'd quickly become a demon. That demon would quickly be killed by Indra, and then Chitraketu would quickly come back home back to Godhead to be with Krishna.
Жить как Читракету, это еще будет тысячи лет до того, как он его увидит наконец-то. Поэтому он вдохновил Парвати так, чтобы она прокляла его, тот стал демоном. Демона быстро убил Индра, и вскоре уже душа Читракету была воскрешена.
So you don't see fault in Shiva, don't see fault in Parvati, and don't see fault in Chitraketu. It was all the Prem Vilas, the play of love.
То есть произошла такая лила Прем Вилас, то есть все тут безупречно повели себя, но Господь так устроил, что Парвати дала проклятие Читракету.
But Parvati, she was feeling, I am so fallen. I don't have prem because I made offense to a pure devotee.
Позже Парвати сокрушалась. Она считала себя повинной в том, что она прокляла чистого преданного.
So she came here to Navadvip Dham, where one becomes free from offenses.
И решила прийти сюда в Навадвип Дхаму, чтобы освободиться от реакции за свои
оправдания. And began to worship the most merciful form of a Supreme Lord.
И так стала поклоняться самому великодушному
Weeping.
Господу. Рыдая.
And calling.
Гоу!
And very soon, Mahaprabhu appeared before her.
Махапрабху предстал перед ней.
There he is.
Вон он стоит.
And Mahaprabhu, he gave blessings. He said, I am very satisfied with you.
Mahaprabhu благословил её, сказал, я доволен твоим служением.
You can ask from me anything you want.
Проси у меня что хочешь.
She said, oh, I am a great offender. Please bless me with ecstatic prem.
Она сказала, я великая оскорбительница, благослови меня экстатичной премой.
Mahaprabhu said, you have not made any offense. Be peaceful.
Mahaprabhu сказал, ты не волнуйся, ты ничего неправильного не сделала.
And always stay. Because stay here, because I cannot perform any pastimes without you.
Оставайся тут, потому что без тебя я не смогу явить никакие лилы.
Because the original Swarupa Parvati is not material energy, but Prauda Maya Devi.
Что изначальная форма Парвати это не материальная энергия, а Прауда Деви.
Just like in Braja.
Йога Майя. Во Враже.
The gopis are worshipping Yoga Maya.
Гопи поклоняются Йога Майе.
Йога Майя Махамайе. Mahayogina Dishvari Nandagopa Sutam Devi Patime Kurute Namaha. They worship Durga in the form of Katyayani, and she's Yoga Maya, the Leela Shakti, who arranges for to fulfill their desires.
Во Враже гопи поклоняются Дурге в форме Катьяни, то есть это Йога Майя, которая исполняет их желания там.
So her form here in Navadvip Dham is a Prauda Maya.
А в Навадвип Дхаме Йога Майя принимает форму Прауда Майи.
So then, Gauranga Mahaprabhu, after revealing this mystery to all of you and me, then Gauranga Mahaprabhu disappeared. Then Parvati, where his footprints were, she took the dust from where his footprints were and she put them on the parting of her hair.
Там, где до этого стоял Махапрабху, остались его следы, и Парвати потянулась рукой, собрала пыль с того места и нанесла себе на пробор на голову.
So, a married woman, as a sign of complete one-pointed dedication and chastity to the service of her husband, she put sindur on the part of her hair. This is suhag.
Suhag?
The sign of the chastity to the husband.
Знак верности мужу. В ведической культуре женщина в знак верности мужа наносит красную краску себе на пробор.
So Parvati, she decorated the parting of her hair with the foot dust of Gauranga to as a sign of her one-pointed, complete, unconditional dedication to the eternal service of Gauranga Mahaprabhu.
Парвати нанесла себе на пробор волос пыль со стоп Гауранги Махапрабху как символ своей верности ему.
So, if you have any inclination to worship Durga, you can really please her by serving Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Если вам нравится служить Дурге, то знайте, что лучший способ угодить ей – это служить Чайтанья Махапрабху. Это действительно порадует.
Because the parting of the hair in Sanskrit is called Simanta, so this island is called Simanta Dvip.
Пробор на санскрите – это Симанта, поэтому этот остров называется Симанта Двипа.
And this particular form of Parvati is Simantini Devi.
Это Симантини Деви.
Симантини Деви ки!
Jai!
Simanta Dvipa ki!
Jai!